Welcome, Nyasha, and then this is Nana, and then I'm going to show you a demo on what to see in Toto. So let me go and then share my screen now. Click on share screen, and then I'm into this place. Let me go into the order management part of it now. Click on order management. And then let me create a new order now. I click on create new order. So the customer is test. Underscore customer to your tab. I will now choose the customer over here. So once the customer is chosen, you will now choose the business unit. I should have done this first, afterwards populated the customer. So we go there, drop it down, and then choose the bid to customer. And that's it. And then choose the order type as sales order. So the header is now completed. Let me go and then populate the lines now. The LPG, and then I give a tag. So this is the LPG bulk gas, which I'm going to use now. Click on OK. It says it is in stock. Let me go for 50 kgs now. 50 kgs. So 50 kgs is now saying low. Inventory available is only 16. So let me go for 15 now. Fine. We have only 16, so I'm now going to go for 15 now. 15 kgs now. So it's in stock. Let me add the line to it now. So the line is now added, and that's it. So we have completed the creation of a sales order. Let me save and submit. Click on save, and then you will now find the sales order number coming up over here now on the left hand side top. So 12009 is the sales order number. So let me submit it. So click on submit. By which, what happens? The orchestration process will now begin. It will be interfaced into shipping. And so what happens, the item becomes eligible for shipping now. So 12009 is now coming up over here now. So you can see the process is not started. So let me go to actions and then click to switch to fulfillment view. I'm switching it to fulfillment view. And then here, I go to the fulfillment lines. I go to the fulfillment lines. And then here, what happens, I go down. And then click on the orchestration number. So 12009 is the order number for 15 kilos now. And you can see the scheduling has started. The reservation has started. The shipping activity is yet to start. Fine. It will not take some time now. So let me go and then refresh on the top now. Click on the refresh button. So once when it is refreshed, what happens? It has to become as what? Awaiting shipping. So once when the status progresses to awaiting shipping, that means what? The item is now ready for shipment now. Fine. Click on refresh now again. Wait for some time. It takes some time, and then what happens, it has now gone to awaiting shipping. So that is now ready for shipping now. So let me take a copy of this URL and then open up one more tab region now. I take a copy of it, control T to open up one more tab region, paste this URL, and then entering up to com. I've taken a copy and then I'm entering in. So here what happens, I go to the shipping now. Fine, I go there, go to the warehouse operations now straight away. I click on the warehouse operations, we go there. You go to warehouse operations. Here it is there. I click on it. And then here, I will now go to shipments directly. Click on shipments now. Warehouse operations shipments. So we are now coming to the shipments now. I will now choose the organization C101. Click on OK. Now click on the magnifier. On the other day, what I was doing is, I have kept it as shipments. And then here I have kept it as order. And then I queried 12009. This was a mistake which I made now. It should have been lines actually. So it was not coming on the other day. So if you click on it, you don't come anything at all. Nothing is coming over here now. So let me cancel it and then I will now make the correct query now. The query was wrong on the day. So let me click on this now and then change it to lines. And then the order number is 12009. This time it will come now. This was a simple, silly mistake on the day we made. And then because of it, what happened, it was not coming. So make it as lines and then go for order and then click on query. It will not show you. So now it has come over here now. This line has come over here. Now we have to first of all make an auto create of a shipment. Right? Auto create shipment, when you click on, what happens? The shipment from location to two location is now getting automatically created. So the shipment number is 5002. It has created it. So from is what? Your Nairobi facility, and then two is the customer's location. So it creates a shipment for the from and to location. So 5002 shipment is now ready. Click on OK now. Fine, 5002 is ready. So now here what happens, I go to actions and then I will now do the pick release. So it will not pick it up from the place and then bring it to the staging area. Fine, click on actions, pick release. That is the next activity. You click on actions, pick release. By which what happens here? Concurrent is now submitted for doing the pick release. Click on OK now. So this activity is completed. Click on confirmation, click on OK. And that once when this is done, I will now cancel it. Fine. The activity is now complete. The picking, fine, click on cancel. Now the item would have been staged. It says it's staged. Staged means what? We have now picked up from the finished good location and then brought it to the staging area. Now it is ready for shipment now. I will now again give one more cancel now. So we are going to cancel it. Cancel it and then bring it to the main area. And then it says that one consignment is now ready for shipment. Fine. We can even query on the shipment number. It will also show. Fine. If you click on this number, what happens? It will now show this now. This comes to this page. Fine. So this page can be brought even for the main query also. Fine. Cancel it. Fine. Cancel it. And then here, I will now again go via the magnifier. This time, I am going to query the shipment number of 5002. We go to the shipments now. And then here, I drop down and then make it a shipment. And then here, I'm going to query 5002 as a shipment number. Fine, click on it. Now, this will come. So, from there also, you can query. Or otherwise, from the magnifier icon also, you can query. Now, perform a ship confirmation. So, order number is 12009, for which what happens? 15 kgs has been shipped now. Fine. It is not giving you a lot of warnings. So, what happens? It says what? The item is not having weight and volume. We can ignore this. There is no weight and volume for this, not fine. And then similarly, these two lines can be ignored. And then here, what happens when you load it onto the truck? So we have to, if you want, we can create a bill of lading. Bill of lading says what has been loaded on the truck, and then what is the origination, what is the destination. And then if you want a document to be printed and then handed over to the driver, then we have to create a bill of lading also. As of now, it is bypassed. And then we will now decide later whether to create a bill of lading document or not. So upon ship confirmation, what happens? This document will be printed on your printer's design. So we will not decide that and then we will not generate that document. So this is the only thing, the warning, which is only a warning message. These two can be ignored. This one we will not decide later. So click on yes now. Fine. That's it. Fine. The ship confirmation activity is now complete. So in the entire shipping process, we are going to launch the pick release. Initially, what happens? We will now auto-create the shipment, then launch the pick release and then perform the ship confirmation. So once when you completed it, what happens? You go there and then this place. Right? You go to the manage orders and then here, if you refresh it and you know awaiting shipping, if you click on refresh now, click on the refresh button. Now you can see there's a change in the status. It is still showing awaiting shipping. It is not yet updated the order now. It has already been shipped and then invoice has to start now. So we'll now wait for some time and then what happens? You can do this now. Reduce it now. So you can see awaiting shipping and not started. Click on refresh again. What happens? Now it says it's shipped now. Fine. It is not shipped. And then invoice process has started now. Invoice process has started now. Fine. Click again on refresh. It will now say awaiting billing. So 12009 for 15 kgs is now shipped and then it is now waiting for invoice now. Fine. Click on refresh. Again, click on refresh. Now it has gone to the awaiting billing now. So let me come out of this and then what happens now? My financial person, Bitree, will now show you the creation of the invoice part of it. Click on done. So I will now come to the main screen. Click on done again and then come to the main screen. So now 12009 is now awaiting billing. Fine. Now I will now hand over the mic to Bitree and then he will now demo it for this billing part. Let me log out of this now. Click on sign out. So 12009 for 15 kgs will be demonstrated to by Vivitree now. Over to Vivitree.
A warm greeting to everyone who are seeing this video. Right now I am going to do the process of auto invoice creation. Till now the shipment has been shipped but yet the invoice has to be created. For that purpose I am creating the auto invoice. Right now, I'm going to log in into as financial users. System has logged into the home screen. click on the navigator. Below tools, select scheduled processes. Click on schedule processes, new processes. Select the drop down. And select search button. Enter the concurrent name as import auto invoice. Select the concurrent and press OK button. One more time, select OK. It will ask a confirmation message. By default, the business unit name will be automatically entered. Select the transaction source as distributed order orchestration. This is the source where we have defined for the import auto invoice lines. Under other information, it's not necessary to enter. The main things that we have to enter are business unit and the transaction source. After entering the business unit and transaction source, click on submit button. A confirmation message will occur. Click on OK button and close. Refresh the page by selecting a refresh icon. Right now it's running. We have to wait till it succeeded. Click on the refresh icon till the import auto invoice execution report status converted to a succeeded, where we can see the invoice that has been created based on the sales order. Now the status have come to succeeded. Click on the import auto invoice execution report, and below the screen there is a drop, there's a cursor. Please scroll it down and you can see the output header. Below template, auto invoice execution report is there. Click on it and select republish button. Select the actions icon, which has been indicated as settings button. Click on HTML, where we can see the output in HTML format. See, how many lines have been selected, how many have been successfully processed, and number of transactions, number of lines are one, and the total amount is 1800. Right now, I will pass the mic to Mr. Nana about explaining about the sales order return. Thank you.
Welcome back. And then what happens? We are now going to do a return of the consignment now. Fine, go there. So let me close this order invoice part. Fine. This is the monitoring process. And then the signing. Fine. Here, what happens? Let me sign out of this now. Let me sign out of the financials and then let me come into the CM now. Click on a confirmation, and then here I'm going to sign in as SCM user. So SCM user is the one, click on sign in, and then we go inside. Now we are going to process the return for the same sales order 12009. Click on the order management. And then here in the task, you go there and then go to manage orders, and then I'm going to query my existing sales order. The sales order is .12009, and I click on search now. So once when you make a search, it will be coming over here now. You click on the order number and then open up the order now. I click on the order number and then I'm opening up the order. And then here I'm going to process the return now. So you can now see the status is closed, mainly because what happens, the invoice is created. So once when the invoice is created, the status goes to closed. You select the line, and then here I'm going to make a return now. I click on return now. So out of 15, I'm going to return 5 kgs at the rate of 120. If I click on return now. Now, you've got multiple options of return now. Fine, go there. We can say that what the cancelled item itself, you're going to cancel it, or otherwise return only for credit. So we are going to only make a credit memo, and then we are not going to make any inventory result. The third option is create the item, create the credit memo as well as return the item. Fine, this is what is applicable now. Fine. So click on it. Return for credit and return the item is the one I'm choosing it now. And then you can even choose the appropriate reasons. This reasons can be populated through a lookup code now. And I'm just choosing this one. So whichever is more appropriate, we will now populate the reasons as you required by you. Click on create order. I'm not going to create an order for 5 quantities now. Fine, only 5 quantities. Make a change of this 15 to 5 now. So for 5 quantities. So the entire 15 is returnable, out of which only 5 is getting returned. Click on create order. The system creates a new order. 12009. So what happens? It will be creating a new order. So 12010 is now created. Let me submit it for processing. And you can see everything coming in red. That is what? It is a negative quantity now. I click on save and submit. By which what happens? The return sales order, which is known as a return material authorization, is now ready for processing now. Now we have to go to the inventory, and then what happens? We have to receive this item. So it says the status is now created. You go to actions, and then what happens? We now go to switch to fulfillment view. So by which we can now have a look at the fulfillment view. Here you go to the fulfillment lines, there will not be anything at all because it is a return. So this time what happens, we should not go to fulfillment lines. We have to go to returns and then process the orchestration. Here in the returns, you'll be having so many things. In the orchestration process number, if you click on it, fine. For the return, we have to go via the returns now. Fine, click on the orchestration process number. It says it is awaiting receiving. It needs a receipt in the, what's called your gate, or rather in the inventory. So let us take a copy of this now. Take a copy of it, and then go to Control T, and then go for a new tab, and then paste it over here, and then entering. So now we are going to make a receipt now. Fine. 12010 is the sales order number for return now. Fine, click on it, and then let me go to the warehouse. I'm going to the warehouse. So go to the warehouse operations, and then here, what happens? Click on it, and then click on shipments. But not shipments now, receipts now. So we are going to make an inventory receipt of it now. Fine, click on the receipts. Previously, we have shipped through shipments icon. Now we are going to receive the RMA via receipts now. Fine, click on the receipts. We are going to make a receipt now. And then choose org over here. C101 is org. I'm choosing it. And then click on OK, by which part of the org gets collected. So click on this icon of task. It contains all the tasks. And then click on what? Receive expected shipments. Right. Click on receive expected shipments. And then here, what happened? The RMA number is 120. The RMA number is 12010. Then you tap. And then I'm going to put this number and then make a query now. Make the due date as null and then make a query now. Right. Make the RMA number as 12010 and then click on search now. So what happens? You'll be getting it. So RMA number is the one by which what happens? We have to make a receipt into this now. Right. RMA stands for Return Material Authorization. So here, what happens? You go there and then choose it and then click on receive now. I'm going to make a receipt now. Fine, click on receipt. So click on receipt. So here, what happens? You put the quantity as 5. All the 5 quantities are getting received now. And then drop down the sub-inventory. So we have made a change now. In the purchasing receipts, what happens? We are now going to make a 3-step process. One is a gate receipt, and then afterwards inspection, and then afterwards delivery. Whereas in the case of RMA, we have made it as a direct receipt. And if you want this also to be examined, then we can now make a change from a 1-way to 2-way or 3-way, depending upon the requirement. And then we have to choose this gas store over here now. It is a single step process of a receipt now. Fine, click on create receipt. The RMA receipt is a single process. This can also be made as a 2-way or a 3-way, just like what we make in the other one now. So click on create receipt. So I'm now going to make a receipt now. So once when you click on the receipts, we can even fill up the shipment number, packing ship number, etc., etc., if they are applicable for you. Otherwise, click on submit directly. So by submitting it, what happens? The RMA gets processed. Click on submit. The RMA gets processed now. A confirmation message is coming. A GRN number is now created, 1014 for this. So I click on OK. So what happens? The RMA gets processed. Now, this will be updating the return sales order automatically over here now. Here, what happens? You go there. You go to the manager orders. And then here, if you refresh it, Now what happens? It will now say click on refresh. Upon refreshing it, one more thing we have to do. We have to run a concurrent. Fine. Send receipt confirmation is a concurrent which you have to run now. Fine. We have to run a concurrent. So let us go and then create one more tab region now, and then paste it over here. Fine. And then enter it. We have to run one more scheduled process for pushing this information into the sales order. We go there, click on it, and then here I will now go to the scheduled process. Go down. Below the tools, it will be there. Fine. Click on more now. So below tools, you'll be having a scheduled process. Let me go to the scheduled process over here now. Let me go to the scheduled process. And then here, what happens? I'm going to click on the schedule new process. So drop down. And then here, we go down. And then click on search. This is called send receipt confirmation. Yes, S-E-N-D. Remember, this case sensitive. Fine. Result percentage C-O-N. So the first letters are basically capital, and then make a search now. Send receipt confirmation is a concurrent which I'm going to do it. Select it and then click on OK, by which what happens? We are going to run this concurrent. This concurrent will now communicate back to the sales order from this place. And then what happens? It will be doing it now. So let me submit it now. So I'm now going to run this credit point. So organization is C01, it is a mandatory one. So drop it down. CC101. And then one more thing is source system, drop down. In the source system, what happens? Oracle's distribution, Oracle order orchestration and planning. Once again, something on the orchestration has to be chosen now. I think this is a more appropriate one now. Fine. Choose the Oracle Fusion order orchestration and planning. We'll now drop down and then have a look at it again now. This is the only one which is available. So choose it, and then the remaining are not mandatory, and then click on submit, by which what happens, the shipment system will be communicating back to the orders order management system. So inventory is now getting interfaced into order management now. Right, on it, and then click on refresh it now. So once when this is completed, the sales order will be updated. So should simple like this, now set receipt confirmation is now running. Run it. So send receipt confirmation is not running. So once when this is completed, what happens? You now see the sales order is now will be interfaced to AR now. It will be interfaced to AR. Fine, awaiting with the awaiting billing status. Fine, it is not completed. So let me go back and then see how this plays now. So here. Okay. So it's refresh now. Fine, click on refresh. Okay, you can now see the monitoring process. Let it get succeeded now. Fine, it is completed. It is now succeeded. So the final status is succeeded. That sees what send receipt confirmation is now succeeded. So here, go there. We will now go to the manager orders and then click on refresh again. So here it was awaiting shipping. Now what happens? It's like delivered now. And then it has gone to the awaiting billing. So 12010 is now awaiting billing, and then has been interfaced to AR now. Now Vetri will now take over, and then he will now demonstrate the process of invoice creation as well as payment also this time. Last time he has not done it. Here, what happens? The system automatically adjusts this return against the original invoice. And click on it. That. So he will be explaining about that in a greater detail. And click on it. And then I will now show this now. Fine. Click on. Come out of it now. Let me log out of the screen. Sign out. And then I will now hand it over to you now for doing the receivables part of it now.
Hi everyone, right now we are going to see about how to create a credit memo, the same process what we did for auto invoice creation. I'm going to log into as financials. Path navigator, click on navigator, followed by schedule processes. Click on schedule new process, select the drop down, click on search button, in the name text box enter import auto and press enter button, select the import auto invoice, click on OK, and again one more time OK button. Now a process detail screen will appear. in that we have to select the transaction source as this distributed order orchestration, where we are using the source only for auto invoice creation, and click on submit button. Confirmation message appears. Click on OK and close the screen. Now click on refresh icon. Concurrent runs right now. Normally three concurrents will run. Import auto invoice, import auto invoice execution report, notify feeder system of receivables transactions. In import auto invoice execution report, we can see the transaction which have been imported right now. It has to get succeeded. Now it got succeeded. Click on it. Select the scroll down button. Below template, select the auto invoice execution validation report. Click on it and select the republish. And actions, click on actions, export to HTML. We can say the transaction source, default date when it has been imported, and the number of lines processed, rejected. See? Totally there are 5 quantities have been rejected. 120 into 5 is equal to 600. This is the output report of the credit memo. Close this screen and click on home button. Right now, I'm going to show how the invoice credit memo has been adjusted to the invoice. For that, click on receivables, billing. Okay. Select on the task list, manage transactions. We can search via two processes, but in the search criteria there are two asterisks which is more mandatory, and at the same time below transaction we can see that at least one is required. That means transaction source, transaction number, transaction date, bill to customer. In these four categories at least one is required. So right now I'm going to select the transaction sources distributed order orchestration. Click on it and select search button. You can see the difference between the invoice and the credit memo. Whereas in the invoice has been created with the number starting number as 1, but when it comes to credit memo, system automatically creates the credit memo invoices with starting number 2. So today we have raised the invoice as well as credit memo. You can see. Sorry, I just selected the wrong invoice. Right now I'm exiting the invoice. Yes. This is the invoice. The total amount of 1800 KES. Click on actions, and we are going to see how the credit memo has been applied to this invoice. For that, we have to select on view balances details that is pertaining to this particular customer. You can see that original amount is 1800. We have entered a credit memo with the amount of -600. So the remaining balance, remaining amount we are going to get from the customer. So click on done button and save and close. If needed, or else we can select the cancel button and click on done. One more time, click on home icon. click on receivables. Billing accounts receivables for making a manual AR invoice as well as AR credit memo and some other related stuff. We can select the billing, but when it comes to receipt, that means when you're going to get a payment from a customer, you have to select these accounts receivables. Click on the task list. Select create receipt below receipts. Make sure that the receipt type as standard and the status is new. That means we are going to create a new receipt for this customer. By seeded, the business unit will be automatically entered. Select the receipt method where you have created a separate receipt method for this business unit. The receipt number is nothing but the check number or a payment number that you receive from the customer with a reference number. Making this transaction, I am entering as 456789. Let us assume that this is a check number that we received from the customer. Enter the amount as some random numbers. In some cases, we may not be sure that the amount entered is correct or incorrect. So I'm entering it as 500. Fine. Now scroll down the screen. We have to enter the customer for which we have received the payment. Sorry. I forgot to show the navigation. Below customer, there is a text box which is near to the name. Select the magnifier icon. Right now we made an invoice for test_customer2. Enter the customer name and select search button, or else click or enter button in the keyboard. And select. We have selected the customer by selecting OK button, and we have to manually enter the site. That means we have given the site name, but you have to select it manually by clicking the scroll down icon which is next to site. After filling these relevant information, click on the drop down which is next to submit and create another. Click on submit and apply manually. See, right now we can see entered account amount is 500, accounted amount is 500, unapplied amount. This means that we haven't applied any invoice to this receipt. To apply the receipt, click on add open receivables and enter the customer name. The same case where we have to enter at least any one of the search criteria which have been indicated as double asterisks. Right now I'm entering as test_customer2 and select search, or else by clicking enter button. See, 1200. Right now I'm changing the amount. Fine. Right now I have changed both in the entered amount as well as the applied amount. Since the invoice amount consists of 1200 KES, where 600 have been recorded as credit memo, so click on save. Now you can see that entered amount as 1200 and total applied amount as 1200. That means this invoice has been fulfilled with the exact amount which have been created as a receipt. Click on save and close. fine. To recheck, to re-query the receipt that have been created, click on manage receipts. And same test underscore customer two. You can search. Fine. 10th February. This is the receipt number that you have created, which have been come to status. That means confirm status. Click on save and close. We can see it in the AR invoice screen itself, whether it has been paid or not. For that, I have selected the home screen. Click on receivables. Click on billing. And select the task list. Click on manage transactions. Select the source as a distributed order orchestration. And click on search button. For this invoice right now, we made a payment. For that, you have to click on this invoice number 2004, and you can see the invoice screen. Select the actions and select view balance details. Fine. You can see that overall it has been nullified by 1800 minus 1200 is equal to 600. 600 minus 600 is equal to 0. If we want to see the receipt that have been made for this invoice, select on actions followed by view transaction details. You can see that activity class has credit number been created, as well as the payment. The receipt number 456789 has been created for this invoice. Click on done button. That's all for the day. Right now we have shown you about how to create a sales order and how it has been converted into AR invoice, as well as how to create a sales return and how it has been moved to credit memo, and we have also seen that how the invoice has been adjusted, credit memo has been adjusted to the invoice, and we have seen about how to make a payment for an invoice. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Then thank you all for listening to this O2C session now. Bye. Thank you so much.